She remarked then that there was no extra horse in the bunch. It seemed strange, her thinking that, and she imagined she was not clear headed. "Throw the packs, Bill," said Kells. Another fire was kindled and preparations made toward a noonday meal. Bill and Halloway appeared loquacious and inclined to steal glances at Joan when Kells could not notice. Halloway whistled a Dixie tune. Then Bill took advantage of the absence of Kells, who went down to the brook, and he began to leer at Joan and make bold eyes at her. Joan appeared not to notice him, and thereafter averted her gaze. The men chuckled. "She's a proud hussy, but she ain't fooling me. I've knowed a heap of women." Whereupon Halloway guffawed, and between them, in lower tones, they exchanged mysterious remarks. Kells returned with a bucket of water. "What's got into you men?" he queried. Both of them looked around, blusteringly innocent. "Reckon it's the same that's ailing you," replied Bill. He showed that among wild, unhampered men, how little could inflame and change. "Boss, it's the unaccustomed company," added Halloway, with a conciliatory smile. "Bill sort of warms up. He just can't help it. And seeing what a thundering crab he always is, why, I'm glad and welcome." Kells vouchsafed no reply to this, and, turning away, continued his tasks. Joan had a close look at his eyes, and again she was startled. They were not like eyes, but just gray spaces, opaque openings, with nothing visible behind, yet with something terrible there.